please step away from the car? Hi, Jack. How are you doing?
Sorry about that, guys.
I used to follow this car, dirt road,
okay,
in Newark, in 1950, 60, you know, 58, 60.
Mm-hmm.
And that gravel came from that dirt road.
Wow, that's crazy. That's unbelievable. And surviving this car that long, that's crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we didn't even notice it until 2 years ago. It's wild.
And you've owned the car for how long?
I've owned it for 59 years.
And you just noticed it 2 years ago.
Yeah, just noticed it.
Well, because they cleaned out the engine.
Yeah,
well, finally.
It was stuck up in there
after long enough.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
That's insane. That's pretty awesome, guys.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yep, well, I'll see you guys around.
All right, awesome.
Yep. Bug's beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Did you get the card this past Saturday over at the Volksfest show?
I did not take it. I just went and looked around.
I was there as well.
Were you? Nice. Yep. Nice. Yeah, if I go that far, I feel like I got to sit around all day. I just wanted to go look around.
Of course. It's always needed to be there all day. I kind of was. And I didn't have a car.
Yep,
I was still there all day.
Yep. Yeah, there's so much to look at there, and so many things, notes, and talk to people.
Absolutely, it's some beautiful cars.
Yeah.
I've always been a fan of Beatles since I was a kid.
Yeah.
I've had two of the 90s new Beatles.
Okay. Yeah.
In the past, so Bugs are part of who I am, part of my blood.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I mean, I love the old ones. I love the new ones. Yep. I mean, I kind of love all eras of them.
Yeah. They are wonderful cars.
They are.
I eat, drink, sleep Volkswagens.
Well, he seems to be bitten by the bug.
Absolutely.
And they're in your blood, so.
I've been driving, yes, since I was 17, yes, and I have always had several.
That sounds
great. My favorite bug, though, so.
Obviously.
My forever bug at this point, hopefully.
Yeah. Nice. So, I bet if they took a sample of your blood, it wouldn't be red, it'd be symbols of VW.
Yes, that's right.
yep, that's awesome.
Absolutely.
I see the same thing about myself, so.
Nice.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Gorgeous car, buddy.
Thank you.
Gorgeous.
Thank you.
I'm jealous. I would love to have it. So.
Oh, I'm John, by the way.
I'm Ryan.
Ryan, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I built the motor and stuff, so I'm not a body guy, but I'm a mechanic. So
of course.
I'm in the shop, and the motor is what I love.
And I'm sure that these air-cooled engines and these Beetles are a lot easier to work on than what you might have in one of these cars on the side
of
yours.
I love the simplicity.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Three wires.
I don't know anything about car mechanics, but I'm sure I can learn it.
Used to. Yeah.
I don't know if he still has a VW.
No, he's,
or not.
I'm sorry. He sold it.
Did he? Okay.
He sold it. Actually, we brokered the deal for him.
Okay.
For his bug. His dad passed away and he inherited his dad BMW.
I'll see you around, buddy.
Right.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yep.
Take care, man.
You too, man. Yep.
You're right. He bought his dad BMW.
Yeah.
Come this way,
guys. Oh, sure.
What year is it?
Spare tire.
1957.
57?
Is the paint original?
It's not the original paint, but it is the original color.
Oh, okay.
This car was restored in 2011, so they applied the original color.
Mm-hmm.
Chevrolet called it Harbor Blue.
Okay. And when did you get the car?
2 years ago.
Two years ago, okay.
Yeah, nice.
Where'd you find it at?
Dartmouth, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
I've been looking every day, two summers ago, almost every day I looked online, different websites that had classic cars for sale, and I knew I wanted this exact model, I wanted this color, preferably already restored.
Uh-huh.
Older restoration preferred, because if you get a new one, the price is a lot higher, and it's so near perfect that you don't want to drive it.
Right.
But if you get one that's an older restoration, like this,
uh-huh,
go out and drive. And it still looks nice, and it runs great, and you can still enjoy it. So anyways, every day I looked online for an hour or two, and I would find more websites that sell classic cars, auctions, whatever. And I found out, so when I called on a few, in fact, there's a couple I went and looked at in Missouri, and it wasn't as good as advertised, came home disappointed.
Right.
But anyways, others that I called on, if they did answer the phone and talk to me, some didn't, but if they did, they would say, it's already sold, and the common theme was, the first person who came and looked at it bought it.
Right.
So I thought, well, if I ever find one I really want, I need to be the first one there to look at it.
Exactly.
Otherwise, yeah. So anyways, called the lady up. So I found it one day on the site and thought, it wasn't there yesterday.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't on this website for sale yesterday, but it is today.
Uh-huh.
So I called her up, Dartmouth, Massachusetts,
uh-huh,
asked her some questions. Unfortunately, this was 2 years ago, unfortunately, her husband, she's elderly. She said her husband apparently died a year and a half earlier from COVID.
I'm
very sorry to hear that. Anyways, he had 5 cars in his collection, and this was one of them. And she was not interested in cars, so she decided to sell the cars, including this one. And now I didn't tell her what I told you about every car I call on, if it's sold,
yeah,
first person to look at it.
Uh-huh.
So I wanted to be the first, but I didn't tell her that.
Uh-huh.
So I asked her, can I come out and look at it right now? Again, Dartmouth, Massachusetts, near the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah.
I was just like, from here?
It's a 14 and a half hour drive one way.
Okay.
And she said, well, we have a hurricane coming through this area right now. I said, that's okay. I have strong windshield wipers.
Nice.
I was on the way.
Nice.
I was on the way.
And you went, you bought it. Did you drive it home? Did you trailer it?
No,
or?
I had it put in a trailer, yeah.
Oh, I guess that's about
it. Set up an appointment, went up and looked at it.
Mm-hmm.
There were a few things, minor things I wasn't too happy with. I leveled this one, but overall, great.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I can't be too nitpicky. And the few things I wasn't happy with, I thought I can either fix it myself, replace it myself, or I can hire to have it done. So I wasn't gonna let a few minor things ruin it for me.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it was the color I wanted. It's an older restoration. Overall, it's in great condition.
Mm-hmm.
That was the first one they ever looked at.
Did you have to pay their asking price, or was you able to negotiate?
I didn't want to negotiate. I normally negotiate.
Right.
But no. She could have said, as a matter of fact, I'll come back to your answer in just a second, but after we agreed I was going to buy it, we went into her kitchen, go over the paperwork and how it's going to arrange, and this and that or whatever. She told me that after I called her,
uh-huh,
she got a bunch more phone calls, she got a bunch of emails, a lot of people, she said, wanted to come out and see this car. And she told everyone, it's on hold, because I got a guy driving from Ohio on his way right now, uh-huh, and I can't sell from underneath. So she said, if he decides to buy it, it's sold. If not, she said, I'll get back with you. So if I would have said, I'll offer you less, she could have said, no, I got 20 guys.
Yeah. Get out of here, right?
Yeah, so I bore, and it was a good price.
Okay. Well, she could have said, you know what, because of the demand, I want, you know, I was asking this, but no, I want this much more for it because of the demand, but she could have done that to you. But
well, after I took it for a test drive, I was very honest and straightforward with her. I said, here's a few things I like about it. It's got power steering, it's got power brakes, I like that. Here's a few things I don't like about it. The zip on the back window doesn't zip all the way. You know, a few of the minor things that I really wasn't concerned about, but just to be fair with her, you know. And I said, but overall, it's in good condition, I like the car, and I told her, I will pay you your full asking price. I'm not gonna offer you anything less than that. She started. I walked up to her and put my arm around her and
wow.
It's okay.
Yeah.
So anyways, and so made arrangements, but I didn't want to drive it because it's a 14 and a half hour drive on the highway.
And it's an old car, you know.
You never know, yeah.
Yeah.
So so a friend of mine who wheels and deals in classic cars, he referred 3 different companies to me where they will put it in a box. Semi-trailer,
yeah,
a transporter, and I called 3 of them. One didn't get back with me, two did. Uh-huh. And I went with the one that gave me the best deal. I think it was like $1,100 to $1,200. Uh-huh. Have them transport it from Dartmouth, Massachusetts to my house in Ustream.
Uh-huh.
It just, coincidentally, it happened to be the same company that Jay Leno uses all the time.
Oh, really?
Jay Leno buys cars. Uh-huh. It's the same company. They put that in their little advertising.
Oh, of course.
You know. But I didn't know that at first. Uh-huh. And it wouldn't have mattered anyways.
Wow.
So anyways, lifelong dream car. Finally got it.
Nice. That's awesome, man.
When it was supposed to happen.
I guess so.
I'm excited for you. I wish it was mine, but I'm excited for you. That's an awesome story. Awesome story.
My better half left me. I don't know where he went.
Well, you enjoy. It's good talking to you.
Same here. Enjoy talking to both of you.
Yep. Thank you. Guys.
Thank you.
He's adorable. He's adorable.
Name is Zora.
Hi, Zora. Zora. Hi. Hi there. Yeah. You are adorable.
Oh, no. This is our third single released off that album. It's called Keep On, Keep It On. It's available over here at GM.
Watch it, Graham.
Didn't see him either.
Thank you.
guys enjoy that. We played a lot of our shows this year, and they have all been hot. Man, hot, like, not land.